So hello and welcome to the last session of today, that is second day of 3D printing and design. I welcome VV Narayana Reddy. He will be giving a demonstration of metal 3D printing. So over to you, VV Narayana Reddy sir.
Okay sir, thank you sir. So is it visible my screen sir?
No. Not now. Please share your screen. Yeah.
Is it okay, sir? I share.
No, go to the present now and share your screen. Is it not visible to me?
It's sharing, I think.
Yeah, yeah. Now it is ready to present. Yeah.
Okay. Sir. Thank you, sir. Yeah. So my name is Narayan Reddy. I am the research scholar in NIT Warangal under Ravi Kumar, sir. Today I am going to present the additive manufacturing laboratory facilities available at NIT Warangal, and will focus mainly on metal 3D printing, which is having it here. And also we will explain you the post processing of additive manufactured component. Just I will give that this is a additive manufacturing laboratory. Now we are going to see that what facilities having at my college. See, these are this is only the plastic 3D printed parts machines available in this arena here. Now here these are the some of the softwares which we are using at the NIT Warangal here. And these are the some printer, one of the printer we are using the plastic, that is the Stratasys Mozo 3D printer. And this is extrusion based 3D print. This is one of the 3D printer we are having here, that is a Stratasys Dimension SST. And we are having Ultimaker 2+ 3D printer. And also we are having two more 3D printers. One is the Flashforge Finder and MakerPy 3D printer. This is a reverse scanner. This is object scanner we are having, and this is a DIY 3D printer which are used to assembly a 3D printed component. And this is a metal 3D printer lab we are having here at NIT Warangal. This is a completely metal 3D printer. This is a 3D system metal 3D printer DMP Flex 100 having. This is sponsored by TechCube of NIT Warangal. This is a workstation connected to that machine. Here we are used in this workstation. It's a capability of to do the simulations, everything. This is the post-processing equipment we are having at NIT Warangal. This is all the post-processing equipment like bands, power sieve, muffle, furnace, as well as the short pinning machines and organ cylinders, and as well as we are having oven. Everything we are having here. And I will give a small introduction regarding to the plastic parts and specifications of emissions having at NIT Warangal. I will explain you one by one specifications. So this is the Flashforge printer. This is the Stratasys Dimension SST 3D printer. So this is the FDM based 3D printer we are having at NIT Warangal. See here. There are two print heads available here. One is a support material and the other one is a main part material. See, this is the two print heads which are having here. This is a support material. Left side, right side is a main printer. These are the cartridges. We can feed the material into the 3D printer. Now we can see this is the build volume which we can print by using the Dimension SST 3D printer. So Dimension, the Stratasys Mozo 3D printer, by using this machine we can print the ABS plastic material with a very strong when compared to the Ultimaker and the Flashforge printed 3D printer. This is a built volume. The built volume we can print by using the Stratasys Mozo 3D printer is 127 mm by 127 mm by 127 mm. See here, 127 mm. So these are the some parts which were produced by using this machine. See, these are the some medical parts, especially Ravi Kumar sir students has prepared these parts. And this is a chemical reagent equipment used to remove the support material. This is a So in this chemical treatment equipment, we'll place the part, and this is the, suppose that I want to remove the support material for this this is the part which we have removed already support material. Just I am telling the procedure to remove, how to remove the support material. So in that, the part we will place, the whatever the part which is having support material, that part will placed into that. So we'll place into here, and we'll close. We will close this part, and we'll pour some water or any soluble any soluble liquid, and we'll wait for some few minutes or few hours. The support material automatically will remove the material. Next, we are having, this is the Dimension SST 3D printer we are having in my lab. It is a Stratasys US made company. The build volume is a very large build volume. It is having around 254 by 254 by 305 mm. So it will produce a very large components. It's manifold, wind turbine blade, very large amount of a components we can produce with help of a Dimension SST 3D printer. Now if you see this printer, very large volume we can clearly observe by opening that. And also here, this is also FDM based 3D printer, and here also support material as well as a main material, both are different, and we can fit both by using the two separate nozzles. And so here is a software you are using. Here is a Catalyst EX software. This is used for slicing, and heated extrusion nozzles we are using here, and we can produce a very large size of a component by using this machine. Next, we are having that one of the 3D printer is Ultimaker 2+ 3D printer, which is a very easy to handle, and wherever you want, we can carry and we can do that 3D printing. Here, it doesn't require any system. Just it is required only data connection, like SD cards. This is the, just I'm showing here is the filament, that is a 2.85 mm filament. We are using ABS plastic, nylon, as well as a PVC polycarbonate, everything we can use as a material for printing with the help of this Ultimaker 2+ printer. So this is, in this back side, we can directly feed. That's what is very easy, and very easy to understand, and easy to operate each and everyone by using this 3D printer. These are the some finishing tools we are using to remove the support material. These are very simple finishing tools is required to remove the support material. It's not required any bands or something like that. These are the some components, medical parts, which are produced by using the Ultimaker 2+ 3D printer. Next, the Flashforge Printer 3D printer we are using here. This is also easy to operate when compared to Dimension SST 3D printer as well as a Stratasys Mojo 3D printer. It is having the build volume is around 140 mm by 140 mm by 140 mm. This is a print head as well as a nozzle. Here the material we are using here is ABS plastic, nylon, PLA we are using as a plastic material, and as the nozzle, the size of the filament is 1.75 mm. So 1.75 mm filament. See, the filament is the filament for this material is costing around 1500, which is available easily in the Think3D. They are supplying this material. The cost is very less when compared to that. So next, ion scanner, ion 3D scanner we are using. This is object scanner we are using. This is used to get the exterior dimensions of object. These dimensions we are directly, see, we are having some object, we'll place this object. This is the object which I want to make without having any dimensions. I want to get these dimensions with the help of this scanner. And this will be transferred to the computer, and we'll get the CAD dimensions. The sense scanner we are having, this is a body scanner we are using here. This is also used for reverse engineering purpose, where we don't have the any dimensions. We'll use these scanners and we'll get the required dimensions. Prusa, next is Prusa i3 3D printer. This is a Prusa kit. Generally, it is a very helpful for the students. In my college, the MTech students are working on this DIY 3D printer. This is called DIY 3D printer. In that printer, students are able to assemble and also able to know what are the Arduino software for RepRap movement. And they're only doing, students only did this work, and they performed assembly of these machines. We are having here three DIY printers is having list of softwares which are used here. One of the software is a Materialize Mimix 18.1 version, which is used for medical modeling, medical parts, CT or MRI data. From the data, will separate the where the part, whichever the part we needed, that will be are going to convert it into CAD model. The next is a Materialize 3MATIC 9.0. This is also software which is used for template design for medical data we are using here. Next is a software which are available here is the Stratasys Catalyst EX 3D printer. This is used for slicing of a dimension SST 3D printer. Next is the Stratasys Print Wizard 1.2. This is also slicing software and generation of the G codes for the Stratasys Mozo 3D printer. Next, we are having very high costly software, that is 3D System 3D Expert Ultimate 14.0. This is software we are using for metal 3D printer. In that metal 3D printer, the software is used to analyze the residual stresses and shrinkage effects, as well as generation of a G codes. Everything we are using the 3D Expert software. Next is a Flash Print 14.10. This is used to slicing software for FlashForge Finder 3D printer we are using. Next software we are having is Ultimaker Cura 14.4. These are some parts of our students of Ravi Kumar sir has performed some of the components for their during their BTech as well as MTech experiments, and they successfully completed. These are some medical parts they have been produced, and these are some facials and everything they have been performed, very complex parts, and they are analyzed and very easy to demonstrate for the various applications. Now this is just overall view of metal 3D printing facilities available at NIT Warangal. Now we are actually move on to exactly the metal 3D printing working, which will be explained by my co-scholar Banerjee.
Hello, good morning, sir. Is it audible, sir?
Yeah, audible, sir. Go ahead.
Okay, thank you, sir. Good evening, one and all. This is Banerjee. I am PhD scholar under guidance of Y. Rav Kumar, sir. The laser additive manufacturing is mainly classified into two types, powder bed fusion and direct energy deposition. This direct energy deposition is further classified into wire arc additive manufacturing and laser melting deposition. Here the powder bed fusion, it is this DMP Flex 100, it is under category of powder bed fusion. And the main technical characteristics of DMP Flex 100, here DMP Flex 100, we use fiber as laser and power is 100 watt. Here the scanning speed range is 1 meter per second to 7 meter per second. Means we can vary the scanning speed as per our mechanical properties of the component. If you use high scanning speed, you can achieve fine microstructure. And if it is low scanning speed, we get coarse structure. In this way, we can manipulate the scanning speed as per our requirement. And also layer thickness, it can be adjustable. It is in the range of 30 to 100 micrometer. If increase the layer thickness, we achieve high surface roughness. If you decrease the layer thickness, we can get high surface thickness. Here the material we have using presently in NIT Warangal, precipitate hardening steel and cobalt chromium, aluminum silica 7 magnesium and titanium 6Al and 4B. And this DMP Flex 100 build volume is 100 × 100 × 80 mm. Here we can build X direction in 100 mm and Y direction it is in 100 mm and Z direction it is height of the component it is 80 mm. And loading system is completely semi-automatic. We have to load the powder and unload the powder and fix the substrate, means centering piston, where the laser shoots the piston. These all things we need to do in manually. And CAD/CAM software, here this DMP Flex 100 is only supports 3D expert software. Here we can design the part which we want to print in DMP Flex 100. Here we optimize the supports in such a way that to minimize the powder consumption. And also we orient the part and always we keep part above 45 degrees. And here the CAD software is only read STL, IGS, IGES and step files. These 3D experts only read these format files only. And coming to the main components of the metal 3D printer. Here we can see this is the control panel where we give input commands to the system. It acts as a interface between operator and machine. And here only we upload the file and also we give motions, what are the manipulations are required inside the process chamber. This is the laser assembly window. Here you can observe right and left glow box. With the help of glow box, we can insert the, means we can fix the centering piston, and also we can load the powder and unload the powder with the help of what are the things we can manipulate inside the process chamber with the help of right and left glow box. And this is air box. In the air box, we keep what are the accessories required, like for cleaning the total process chamber, we use fiber brush. And also we load the powder, and also we keep the here the can, powder can, and also all things, what are the accessories required, so we can keep in air box. And this is the characteristics already explained. What is the material build volume and software we use. Before start the mission, we need to open the air and gas valves to create inert atmosphere. This is here you can see pressure regulator also. And this is the process filter. It is behind the DMP flex. The process filter is mainly used to remove excessive fumes generated inside the process chamber. Any dust particles we can remove by process filter. Here, see, there are valves, exhaust valve and inlet and outlet valves, we can see. And here, this is the, again, the air and gas. Before start the mission, we open this air valve and gas valve. This is the main switch. For switch on the mission with the help of this main switch. Here, we can give internet connection. This is the air filter. Is there any dust particle presence in air through compressed air, we can remove. And here the electrical actuators, and there are different electrical compound sensors are present inside the system. And going to inside the process chamber, here you can observe this is supply piston. The supply piston, this is centering piston where laser shoots. This is the platform between centering piston and supply piston. This is the roller. You are completely, you can see this is the scraper, roller, supply piston, and the centering piston. This is the platform between supply piston and centering piston. And this is the excessive, means unmelted, uncentered powder will go to in these cans. There are two cans present here. And you can observe here air box. It is now process chamber side. Here you can observe wire brush, and we can clean the process chamber. We use wire brush, Allen wrench to fix the substrate. Here you can see the air box. Now it is in position of process chamber. Access this airlock system. And this is a laser assembly. Before start the machine, we need to clean laser lenses. It is mandatory for each bolt. Here see lenses inside the laser assembly. As turning the clamp here, we need to clean paper towel with paper towel and to remove any dust particles on the lens. Now coming to general AM process, here we create the CAD part in 3D Expert software and we convert it into FAB3 file. This DMP Flex 100 system only accepts FAB3 files, and after we build the part, this is the final part. If you want to change any mechanical properties like porosity to reduce processes. Porosity, we will do post process. Here the main build process cycle. First we create a build plate loading. We load the build plate on the center piston, and later second step is build plate reference searching. Means the where the build gets start. Means we create the reference to centering piston. Next here material loading and tamping. And here we load the material through glow box, as I explained earlier, and we load the material into supply piston, and later we will do tamping, and later we create powder bed layering. For any part we have to create first layer, okay, in such a way that any voids, any cracks on that. And later we will do lens window cleaning. For each part we have to do lens window cleaning, and later we do process chamber inerting. To create inert atmosphere inside the process chamber, we use process chamber inerting. Next build process starting. This is the starting final. And coming to here, see, this is the build plate. Here we are using 10 mm in NIT Warangal. We clean the build plate with paper towel with degreaser before fixing into the process chamber. Here in process chamber also, in process chamber we are cleaning the build plate with paper towel. We have to clean in such a way that it is in the direction of grooves to avoid any residual on paper towel. And here I am going to explain each process. For each pull, here you can see here whatever motions required inside the process chamber, we can do it with the help of this preparation menu. Here there are three sub menus, like motion menu and atmosphere menu, preparation description menu. Here in motion menu, we can move the carriage forward and backward with the help of these options. And also we can move the roller reverse and forward and backward. And also we can move scraper rise and up. And only the scraper is works up to the platform between means beginning of the centering piston. Later the roller will be work. And also we can move the supply piston, and also we can down the in every time means we have to fill the supply piston in such a way that it should be 3 times more than the pot bull. If suppose pot is 30 mm, we have to fill the supply piston is 90 mm. And here this is a airlock. As I explained earlier, now it is in operator side. The green symbol is up means it is operator side. We keep what are the accessories required, like wire brace and tank plate, Allen wrench and powder cans. We keep what are the accessories required inside the process chamber. Here the green symbol is indicates we can move the supply piston in both direction, up and means upward direction and downward direction. If this gray, it is in yellow color, then we can move it in only one direction. And here airlock system, the lens cleaner. Now the process filter is in closed position. Now these are the motions we have seen. Now we have to fulfill this plate reference, powder bed and anything. As I explained the process cycle, here first we create plate reference, means the where the bolt gets start, means we have to create that position. Now here you can see here the centering piston is above the boundary level. Okay, here this is the platform. It is above the boundary level. We have to down the plate reference below the boundary level, means it is adjust to boundary level. Here click on plate reference. After clicking plate reference, we can see this window. This is the standard plate 10 mm, but we are using 100 mm. We are unclick on it. And finally validate the process. Validate. Now, here you can observe this is the axis initialization is done. Scraper is rising is done. Now positioning the plate. As I explained earlier, we have to position the plate at boundary level. The positioning the plate is not yet done. We do it in manually. Here see, with the down arrow and up arrow, we can move the centering piston. Now it is above boundary level. We are going to keep at boundary level. Now here with the help of the down arrow, we move down the centering piston at boundary level. Validate. Now it is at boundary level. Now search for the potential shock. Search for the potential shocks means the scraper moves over the centering piston. When the scraper moves over the centering piston, if roller touches the centering piston, the shock will be observed. Means the error will come. Means we have to keep centering piston at boundary level. It should not touch roller. We have to keep centering piston in such a way that the roller should not touch the centering piston. Now the scraper moves slowly over the centering piston. We can see. the process is not completed. Now he see the scraper is moves over the centering piston. There is no contact. If there is any contact between roller and centering piston, the error will be occur. Now there is no contact. Now it moves to next position. Now the centering piston moves up by 100 micrometer. Again, the scraper moves over the centering piston. Finally, our aim is to make reference for the pulled plate where the bolt gets taut. Now the scraper moves over the centering piston. We can see here. See, the scraper is moving over the centering piston. It moves up to roller touches the centering piston. Now, okay, there is shock. Now, again the centering piston moves down by 100 micrometer. And again, it will move up by 10 micrometer until roller touches the centering piston. Now it's okay. Centering position is okay now. Totally, it is done. Finally, the reference is done. You can see exact position of the centering piston. The plate reference is done. Now go to powder bed, means deposit one layer. Here, see, now it is completely free from powder particles. And now we are raising the supply piston to create first layer. Now here, see, here we can give layer thickness, means first layer, how much layer thickness is required. We can give it here. And powder raising, how much we can move the supply piston up to 80 micrometer. Iterations mean the scraper moves over the centering piston at one time. Iteration means with required properties validate. Now here you can see the scraper is moving over the centering piston, but there is no layer, means we have to raise the supply piston some extent. Now see, he is increasing the powder raising 500 micrometers. Now he given 3 iterations. Now the scraper moves 3 times. Here you can observe some powder depositing. Still there is no powder. Again we have to raise up the supply piston. Instead of going this, we can move it this motions. Here see, is moving up by supply piston is moving up to create first layer. And now you can see better, you can see the powder is still, there is lack of powder. Here you can see the area between centering piston, it is, there is a gap. We have to fill that. There is gap between centering piston and supply piston. And again he is raising the supply piston. This process is continue until we get required layer thickness without any voids and cracks. It should be uniform throughout platform, like supply piston and the space between centering piston and supply piston. So finally, you see, there is no voids and cracks. It is it successfully create first layer without any voids and cracks. Now we are going to inerting. We create inert atmosphere inside the process chamber. The plate reference is done, means where the bolt gets start. Second one is powder layering. We create first layer without any voids and cracks. Now we create inert atmosphere inside the process chamber. This is the set point, means we have to reduce the pressure up to 1000 ppm. Now present it is 9000 ppm. For that we on the regulation. On the regulation, now you can see the gas valves are open. Now it is 6 liters per minute, but it is very low flow rate. To inert this, now inerting, as clicking on inert, we can increase the flow rate. Now we can reduce the inerting time. 22 minutes 20 seconds. It takes 22 minutes 19 seconds for create inert atmosphere inside the chamber. Now here, see here, the pressure is reducing. It has to reach 1000 ppm. This is our set point. And inside the pressure, okay, when it reaches 25 millibar, this valve will close automatically. This is the inert valve is open, means the gas valve is open. Here the green symbol is indicates the gas valve is open. The process chamber temperature we can see here, 25 degrees Celsius. In this way, we create inert atmosphere inside the temperature, and also we can estimate the time, how much time it takes to create inert atmosphere inside the process chamber. Now, meanwhile, we can upload the file. What means design part? What means what part you are required, which one we have created with the help of 3D Expert software. Yes, see. And here we can observe, these are the objects already placed. Here we can open my computer. You can find your pen drive. Now this is the pen drive. Now he is going to put his pen drive, and you can see his pen drive and also parts which he has designed in Fab3 file format. Now open. Now the file is loading. Here these are the parts, objects we are going to print. Here gyroid, compression test specimens, support lattice and templates. here what are the objects. Here you can see this number indicates how many objects we are going to print, and also here that information also you can see. And if you want to remove any part, you can remove it. Sometimes we need to remove if we have any insufficient powder inside the piston. Here see already while building layer it's showing lack of powder to center this object. We have to click no and we remove the part, but basically for demo purpose we are saying yes. I'm clicking yes. Now here see the layering. You may get doubt like already we did slicing, but why you are still slicing here? But it is for system means controller purpose. It stores data. Whenever you require these parts second time, you directly print it through control system. No need to load the files after bull layers. Here see how many layers, 1914 layers are there. Here the maximum height, Z maximum. This is the Z maximum bull height, 57 mm. Now we can see it each layer and each cross section of the object. Here see, if you want to see 288, at position of 288 layer, you can see the how cross section it is. Here you can observe at position of 288, we can observe the cross section. And if you find any errors, you can stop the machine. And again, we design the part and we reload again. Finally, these are the options. And also here you can see part height, maximum part height 57 mm. How much time, total manufacturing time it is required? 15 hours, 2 minutes, 38 seconds. But the machine estimated time is 13 hours, 49 minutes, 52 seconds. And also if any errors, it indicates. And now the inert atmosphere is 5000. Previous it was 9000. Now it reaches to 5000. Final our set point is 1000 PV. When it reaches, we can start the build. And also here indicates available powder in terms of height. In supply piston is maximum height is 80 mm. In terms of height it is showing 69 mm. Now the powder is filled up to 69 mm. Yeah, see any errors also you can, now the gas is over. Now it indicates me red color. Anything happens, any errors, you can see it here. Now we can observe here, as I explained earlier, here you can see In first layer, we need to sinter twice. Okay, manually we can do this with the help of these options. And sometimes we sinter thrice first layer to maintain strong bond between first layer and substrate. It depends on cross section we have used. If it is more large cross section, we sinter thrice. If it is small cross section, we sinter twice or once. It depends on your part. Now actual process you can see here. You see the laser is centers first layer. Again the roller moves over the centering piston. Here you can here the creating first layer. It centers first layer as per cross section. Here see uncentered powder will go to overflow cans. Later we can collect it. Now see, the roller moves over the centering piston. It creates one layer, and again it centers as per required cross section. This process is repeats until get required component. Here the finally the benchmark is done. Now we are removing uncintered powder. With the help of glow box we are doing this. This is the wire brush, the accessories which we can keep through air box. Is cleaning up. Finally, we get the part. The cleaning process. These are the components we have printed in NIT Warangal with DMP Flex. Here you can see the nameplate. These are directors are N.V. Ramarao Garu, N.V. Ramarao Garu. Here you can see the turbine. You can observe without any supports, we are able to print turbine. And this is the benchmark. To check standards of the machine, we print this benchmark. In benchmark, we can see here we print with different angles and dental implants, lattice structures. Here we use cobalt chromium material. And here you can see cranial implant, lattice structures, and also nozzle. Nozzle also are printed. This is the batch plate. These are dental plants we can see here. These are titanium. See how we can observe how much complicated jobs are printed with the help of DMP Flex 100. We can see it. It is not possible by conventional process. And finally, it is. Okay, my co-scholar Narayana is going to explain about post-processing process. Thank you.
So is it visible, sir?
Yeah, visible.
Okay, sir. So now we are move on to the post processing of additive manufactured metal components, sir. So any additive manufactured any additive manufacturing lab of a metal, we are having these kind of post processing equipment. So one of the post processing equipment we are having here, this is called this equipment is called as sandblasting or short pinning machine. So why it is required short pinning? Everyone knows that the short pinning, which is used to induce the compressive loads and increase the fatigue life of a components which have been produced by using additive manufacturing, and also it is used to improve the surface finish of a additive manufactured components. So what we are doing here, whatever the component we have produced by using the additive manufacturing, the part we are placing inside the chamber of a short pinning machine. The inside chamber atmosphere here is this is a white color, some white color particles which are observed very clearly here. This white color particles are called as abrasive particles. Why abrasive particles is required? So I will tell you later. Now the abrasive particle is environment as well as a very high compressed air we are using. So high compressed air along with abrasive particle is heating the surface of additive manufactured components, and whenever it is in with heating with very high speed or a high velocity, it induces the impact load, and impact load produce the compressive stresses and improve the fatigue strength, as well as whenever it is heating, the surface finish is also improved, and it is observed very clearly. See, after placing this particle, this is the additive manufactured component. See here, this is the air supply where it can shows this supply of air. After that, after operating this in this environment, obviously it increases its properties. So here, this is a glue, so right hand, right, left hand glue, which is used to operate. After completion of the process, we'll take out part from the sandblaster machine, and before that, it is having lesser finish. After the operation, we are increasing the surface finish. Next to post processing unit, we are having here, that is a muffle furnace. It's like a furnace. It is a muffle furnace is nothing but furnace. Furnace is used. What is the purpose of a furnace? See, before going to explain the furnace, we know that the additive manufactured components produced by using additive manufacturing or metal 3D printing, which is so the printed parts is having very fine microstructure. Why we are getting very fine microstructure? We already know that. So it is a very fast cooling process. The part we are printing by using the additive manufacturing process are having the very high cooling, very fast cooling. Due to the very fast cooling, fine microstructures or fine grains are absorbed, as well as due to fast cooling, hardnesses, residual stresses due to fast cooling and high temperature gradient, residual stresses which are developed in a additive manufacturing component. So before going to application of any component, we want to do the stress relieving as well as the residual stresses in the additive manufactured part. So we are using the muffle furnace. See, this muffle furnace is a very friendly and very easy to operate, and it is a very portable. If you see in a BHEL or any other thing, there we are having very large size of furnaces. These are very this is for actual applications. Now in the research point of view, this muffle furnace is a very easy to operate. This is the chamber or environment we are using this muffle furnace. See here, this is a builder. So the part which we want to do the stress relieving, that part will place inside the muffle furnace, and see, we will close this furnace, and see that this is the display or control knob. This is the display as well as a control knobs used to select a program for this material. See here, the maximum temperature in the muffle furnace around 3300 degrees centigrade. See, such a high temperature we are using this with the help of this furnace. So due to high temperature, we can do the stress relieving for every material. We know that maximum melting point for the steel is around 1500, as well as maximum any engineering applications we are having around 2000, something like that only. By using this equipment, which is used to stress relieving all types of machines, we are extensively used for research point of view. in our lab. See, this is the control knobs we are having. This is the display shows the temperature increase by with the help of a knob or control knob. We can change the temperature and we can select the material. See, it is a programmable machine. So in that way, we can feed the material name also, material name as well as a maximum temperature. Everything we can feed and we can control all those things. See here. By using a programmable current and temperature, everything, time, everything, holding time, increasing time and holding time, everything, cooling rate, everything which is show in a, everything which is shown in a furnace, muffle furnace. See that here in our lab, we are using four materials, the aluminium ALSA 7mg and titanium 6 aluminium 4 vanadium. On 17-4 precipitation hardenable material, as well as we are using cobalt chrome. For these materials, we are using the different holding time and different temperature. For example, if it is aluminium silica 7mg, it is heating temperature is around, we are using 270 degrees, as holding time is 2 hours. Like that, each and every material we can select the holding time as well as the holding time. So like the so. Here the environment is, here is we are using the environment, here is a gas environment. It is a furnace cooling, not a open. When we are closing this, the build is entirely in the closed chamber. This is the plate we placed inside. When we are closing this, this is completely under inert atmospheric condition. Here the atmosphere for cooling, we are using the nitrogen as well as argon, whichever you want, that environment we are using here. Suppose that if you want to do the research on different cooling environment, like water quenching, oil quenching, everything we can do. So after completion of holding time, just open this furnace and take this part and place into the whatever the environment we want to do the research point of view, we are using this furnace. It's a very friendly and easy to operate, and this is a very friendly and easy to operate. Any type, anyone can easily understand and operate that. Next to post processing unit we are having here is, that is a bandsaw. Or we know that bandsaw is used to remove the material from the build plate, not for very fine finish. Just it is used to remove the support material from the build plate. Now we fix this. This is a bandsaw we are having. This is called as a head. This is a build plate. We want to fix the build plate to the head, and once we fix that, we will remove the material by using the handsaw. We can remove the part, whichever the part we want to remove from here, that parts we can directly remove. Next is, here is a power sieve we are using as a post processing unit. So it is a one of the best ones we are using at NIT Warangal. See that, what is the purpose of power sheaver? It is a sieve shaker, it is also called. See, already we know that the metal, we are using the metal powder as a material for the metal additive manufacturing of any component. The size of a metal powder is around varying from 20 micron to 60 microns. See that the cost of a metal powder of 1 kg of titanium, it's cost around 22,000. So 22,000 means it's a very high cost. So after completion, already my course scholar is explained metal mission. These unsintered powder particles we have been collected by using the overflow cans. So we are unsintered powder particle we are placing into the meshes, and we are collecting the powder again for reuse purpose. The power siever we are using here is mainly for reusing of a unsintered powder. What we are doing? So in that, see, this is the, in the power sieving, it is a working environment, is a vibratory motion. See here. This is the time that we want to fix, and this is the amplitude. We can increase the amplitude when you, the vibration of amplitude is increases, time taken for collecting will be decreases. So based on the availability of a time and based on your material, we will increase the time as well as the amplitude. Finally, we'll complete that process. Like maximum amplitude here, we are having around 180 amplitudes per minute. Once setting the time as well as amplitude, we will start the mission. When we start the mission, the vibratory motion has been transferred to the upper and the lower. So in the lower one, we'll collect the unsintered powder particle. That powder particle we are using mainly again for reusing of a, in our mission. So we are using, this is the power siever we are using, one of the best, sorry, the one of the component we are using. So here, after completion of everything, we can see the uncintered powder particle. Just it is working. We are giving the amplitude, and we are it's working. Next, see that this is after completion of a process. We have been collected this powder. This is after sieving, we have collected a powder onto the layer. This powder we will again we want to store. So we want to store this powder. This is a collected powder. We want to store this storing of this powder. Before storing this powder, we want to keep in a oven. So this is the oven. The oven is used to remove the moisture attack any moisture in the uncintered powder particle. We are removing that. So the oven here maximum temperature. We are see this is a oven where it is temperature is around 80 degrees preheating of a powder we are using. We are having the preheating purpose. These are the different racks we are having. So in that powder particle, uncintered powder particle will place in a rack. Before using the uncintered reusing of this powder, we want to keep at least 12 hours before using that machine. We want to keep the 12 hours after preheating of a powder in a oven. We will use the reheating purpose. So again, we will load into the machine and we'll complete the remaining entire process. These are the various post-processing equipments which are having at NIT Warangal. This is all about the lab demonstration of a metal 3D printing. So thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Narayana Reddy and your colleague. Request the participants, you can ask the questions.
Any questions regarding metal additive manufacturing?
Any question you would like to ask, you can ask with Reddy sir regarding the process, post processing, machine setup, process parameter, everything they have covered. Still, if you have any query, you can ask. So, okay, thank you, Reddy sir, for your nice presentation or demonstration of NIT Warangal lab of 3D printing. And hopefully, all the candidates get the better idea when we see the demonstration live of 3D printing and the post-processing equipments rather than the PPT and the slides. I hope it will work, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. So, thank you very much, all the participants, for the today's session, and we will meet tomorrow in the first session from 10:30 with the same joining link. The tomorrow speaker will be the Dr. U. Chandrasekhar sir, program director Wipro 3D. They will talk about the recent research and developments in 3D printing. Thank you. Thank you very much to all.